Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. From this video, we will start our Android project, and in this video, we will write our very first unit test using JUnit. Now here I have my Android project and this is just a blank project, and the application that I am going to build in this course is called Spend Tracker. So it is very simple application. We will just enter the amount and the description, and it will save the given info to the local database so that we can also learn how we can test room database or how we can write test for room database. And we will also learn a lot of things, for example, writing tests for view model, for navigation architecture, and many more things that we will see in the coming videos. For now, let's see our project structure. So here you can see whenever we create a project, we get three packages. The first one is where we put all our Android code. We create all the Java or Kotlin classes inside this package. And we also have two more packages. One is, you can see, Android test. We have this info or this hint within the brackets. And one is test. Now these two packages are for test code or for creating the files that are related to testing only. So the first one is Android test, and here we will put all our code related to the instrumented testing or UI testing. So basically whatever test requires the Android specific classes, for example, context, fragment, activities, we will put them inside this Android test package. And then we have a test package, and here we will put all our unit testing code. So basically the raw Kotlin or Java code that do not requires any Android specific libraries. So here we will put all our unit testing codes. Now, if you change the project structure to project, then you can see we have two folders. One is named Android test and another one is named test only. So when you simplify it with Android, you see packages like these. Now in this project, this is basically an empty project, and I have just created a fragment, and this fragment has a design. So we will enter the amount, we will enter the description, and we will hit this button. Now the first thing that we will do in this project is we will write our very first unit test. So as I told you in the previous video, we need to write test case first, and then we will refactor our code, or we will implement the code to pass that test. So basically in our test case, we define the logic for the function. So let's do it. So the first thing that I will do is I will create a object in my main package. So let's create a Kotlin 5 class and I will name it validator. So the first thing that I will do is I will validate the user inputs. So I will create an object, and inside this object, I will create a function, validate input. Now this function is not yet implemented, but I will write the parameters that are required for this function. So the parameters are amount, that is int, and the description, that is string. Now this function is not implemented, but first we will write the test case for this function. So let's create a test case for this function. What you need to do is you need to just right click and go to generate, and we will select test. Now here we will use JUnit 4 and the class name is validator test. You can change it if you want. Now everything else is fine. I will just click OK. And because it is a unit test, the package I will select as just test and not the Android test. So let's hit OK. Now this is my class that is called validator test. Now inside this class, I will create a function that will test my function that is inside this validator object. So the first thing that I will do is I will annotate this class with run with, and we can define JUnit 4 because we are using JUnit 4 for unit testing. So we will define it like this. Now all the functions that you will create for testing, you will annotate it with @test. like this. Now I will create a function, let's say fun, when input is valid. So I will test the case when the input given is valid. So you also need some rules for your input. For example, I don't want any amount that is zero to be saved. So if a given amount is zero, the validation should be failed. So let's do this thing. So I will write here amount equals to zero, but this function says when input is valid. So I will write amount as, let's say, 100, and description as some random description or anything. Now what I will do is I will get the result. So val result equals to, I will use this validator object. So validator dot validate input. I will pass amount and description like this. Now we will add an assertion. And one thing that I just forget, I need to use the Google Truth library for assertions. So we will add this because it simplifies the assertions. Now we all know that to add a library, we go inside build.gradle file. So this time also we will go inside app level build.gradle file. And here you can see we have test implementation and Android test implementations. So if you define a library as test implementation, that means it will be available inside your test package, the only test package. Now if you define a library as Android test implementation, then it will be available inside Android test package, this package. Now if you want your library to be available inside both Android test and test package, then you need to define both things, test implementation and Android test implementation. For example, I will define the test implementation of the truth library, and I can also define the Android test implementation of this Google Truth library. Now we need to sync the project. Now the truth library is available inside both the packages. Now let's go to validator test, and I will remove this JUnit assertion import. Now let's write the assertion. So here we will write assert that, we will use this function and we will pass the result, and we need to import the function that is assert that. And this time we will import the assert that function from Google Truth library. So you can see we have the assert that function, and then we will call the function is equals to, and we should get true. So the point is, whenever we pass some valid amount and description, we should get true from our validate input function. And that is what I defined here. Now to run a test, you can click on this play button, and this play button will run only this test. And if you want to run all the tests inside this class, then you can click on this play button. For now, let's just run this test function. So I will click on this play button and we will run the test. So you can see our test is failed, and first time always our test will be failed because we have not even implemented the function. So our test is failing. Now what we will do is we will refactor our function, or we will implement our function so that it passes our test. So let's implement the function. So I will just write here return, and if amount is less than or equals to zero, or description is empty. So in this case we will return false. That means it is not valid, because we want an amount greater than zero and a description that is not empty. And we also define the return type as boolean. Now we will run the test case again. So let's go to validator test, and here we will rerun the test, and here you can see this time our test passed. Now the same way I will define one more test case when the input is invalid. So when input is invalid. Now this time I will pass the amount as 0, and let's also pass an empty string. And this time this validate input function should return false. So we will write assert that result is equals to false, like this. Now we will run the test again. And you can see the test is passed. So this is how we create unit tests for our functions. So I think that is all for this video, friends. And in the next video, we will move ahead with this project. We will create our database. We will test the database and we will do a lot more things. So in case you have found this video helpful and learned something, you can give me a like. And if you're not already a subscriber, then please hit on that subscribe button and subscribe this channel. You can also click on that bell icon to get the notification updates. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.